Welcome back. As indicated earlier, a new piece of legislation which will govern traditional courts, if approved by Parliament, could strip more than 20 million rural South Africans, and women in particular, of some of their most basic rights. The bill emanates from the policy framework on the traditional justice system under the Constitution. The objective of the bill is to affirm the values of the traditional justice system based on restorative justice and reconciliation and to align them with the Constitution. It affirms the role of the institution of traditional leadership in enhancing access to justice. The bill allows the minister to appoint a traditional leader as the presiding officer of the court without community input. And it does not allow a defendant to have an attorney, nor does it give the defendant the option of being tried in a mainstream court. Civic organizations have slammed the bill as being unconstitutional, but traditional leaders argue that the bill has been grossly misinterpreted by civil society. The president of the Congress of Traditional Leaders, Controlesa, Nkosi Phathekile Holomisa, who is also an ANC MP serving on Parliament's Portfolio Committee on Justice and Constitutional Development, is with me in the studio to give us some clarity on this rather controversial piece of legislation. Good morning, Advocate Holomisa, and welcome to our
program. Good morning, Mr.
Advocate Holomisa, let's first look at the objective of this piece of legislation. The bill is to affirm the role of traditional leadership in enhancing access to justice. Just how is it likely to benefit rural communities, especially women?
Well, rural communities, we don't necessarily discriminate against or in favor of women. We consider all members of our communities as citizens, and therefore we give access to justice to all of them. Now, the bill, as you have indicated, is merely affirming an existing position. We continue to dispense justice in our courts of traditional leadership, either with the support or without the support of any legislation. It's our way of life, and it is guided by Ubuntu. Ubuntu, as everybody seems to be talking about it these days, is our way of life. We look at the interests of the individual as well as the interests of the community and try to harmonize the two, whether you're a woman or not a woman.
The bill makes provision for the minister to appoint a traditional leader as the presiding officer without input from communities. And activists opposed to the bill are of the view that it will centralize power with traditional leaders and would allow them to single-handedly decide on disputes. How do you explain that?
No, that is, of course, nonsense. No official can appoint a traditional leader, not the minister or the president. He merely affirms a recognition that has already been bestowed through custom by the community to that particular traditional leader. So what the Minister of Justice is to do is merely to give maybe something like a certificate so that as a traditional leader already, he can dispense justice. And he does not act alone. A traditional leader always acts in council, meaning with the advice and in consultation with his advisors.
In deciding who should be the presiding officer, do communities have an input in that?
They do through custom. See, when a person, a son of a traditional leader, in most cases, has to be appointed as a traditional leader, the community is informed or consulted on the basis of custom as to whether this particular individual is the legitimate successor to the person who has vacated that position. So by the time the Minister of Justice comes into play, the traditional leader, who is naturally the presiding officer over all traditional matters, is already in place. As there's no need for... I don't understand what kind of consultation or input by the community mean, because as a traditional leader, appointed by your customs and traditions.
This bill does not allow a defendant in a traditional court to have an attorney, nor does it give a defendant an option to be tried in a mainstream court. And according to a community leader in Limpopo, Patrick Mashego, women in particular will be affected because they would not be assured of their right to self-representation. Should a woman's husband die, she would not be protected against those who would want to grab her property.
That again is nonsense, because the distortion of our culture and custom. when a man dies, leaving a wife behind, that wife, now called a widow, has to remain in the same position she was while her husband lived. She's entitled to all the rights and privileges that she enjoyed while her husband lived. If a person stepping into the shoes of the husband comes in on the basis that he's taking over everything now, that is a distortion of our law as Africans. And this question of representation, this bill says a person appearing before the court has a choice to have representation by anyone, family member, a friend, community leader or member. It could even be a lawyer. But the point is that he's not going to come and present procedures that are supposed to be followed in foreign courts, such as we find the magistrates courts, judges courts.
And that actually disqualify a lawyer then?
No, it's not disqualified. You can come in and represent your person, but as a member of the community. Not that you are going to come in, as I say, with your own foreign procedures and processes.
Well, what's your response to suggestions that the bill, instead of making rural people equal citizens in a unitary South Africa, it makes rural people subjects of chiefs who are given coercive power to get rid of those who try to hold them to account?
No, that's an ideological matter. In fact, there was one point you also made earlier, which is that Africans in rural areas are not given a choice of which court to go to. We are not given a choice. If you are required to go to a magistrate's court or a constitutional court, you have no choice. You can't say, no, I'd rather go to some other court. So why should you be given a choice if you have committed a crime or an offense within the jurisdiction of a traditional court?
Some rural leaders opposed to the bill are of the view that the bill will create a crisis around the issue of tribal levies. If people don't pay those levies, traditional leaders refuse to give them a proof of address required when somebody applies for an ID or a social grant.
No, this bill is trying to ensure that the courts act in accordance with the law and the prescripts of the Constitution. So therefore, a traditional leader can't simply what you call deny a citizen their rights merely because that citizen has offended the community in one way or the other. You are not denied your rights, all of them, merely because the magistrate has sentenced you to some kind of a fine or a court, or rather a jail. So you are denied certain privileges, isn't it, and rights, because you are deprived of your right to live with your family and so on, if you are sentenced by a magistrate. So if then it is agreed that for you to comply with the court's decision, certain privileges are going to be denied, that is nothing out of the ordinary.
Nkosi Holomisa, in a paper that you recently released, you suggest that African justice system is superior to Western justice system. What do you briefly imply with that?
Yes, it is. Our justice system is not for sale. You don't get justice because you have money, because you can hire a lawyer. You know, in the current situation, the more money you have, the more likely that you are going to win your case, because you are going to hire the best attorneys or lawyers you can get. And the more senior the lawyers, the more likely that you are going to win your case. And the more senior the lawyer, the more expensive his services. In our court, you are tried by your peers in an open court, in a democratic manner. You have an opportunity to question and give evidence of whatever nature that you can think of. There are no restrictions unnecessary that will prevent you from giving evidence merely because some points of procedure are not complied with.
Nkosi Phathekile Holomisa is the president of Contralesa and ANC member of parliament serving on the Portfolio Committee on Justice and Constitutional Development. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you.
We have to go for a commercial break. Please stay with us.